Do you know what pain is? Pain is scheduling a Halo Infinite tournament between you and your friends after work, only to realize that these same friends that you told to prepare to lose every game are not teleporting when the game starts. Your internet connection is just rendering the game at 1 FPS. Your friends say to you, "One thing that I hate is losing at Halo Infinite. Why do you like it so much?" Now that's pain. Worry not. Here are some tips to get the most out of your experience when cloud gaming. My name is Trisha Hirschberger, and you are watching DIY in 5, the show where we break down tech topics into easily digestible bites in 5 minutes or less so that you can DIY your own tech. Today, we're discussing how to get the most out of your cloud gaming experience so you can stay in the game. If any of the tips in today's video help you out in a bind, give us a like and subscribe so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. Cloud gaming is a revolution. We can now play high-performance video games on devices we already own virtually anywhere. This is now possible because the game engine is running on a powerful server in the cloud, and it's simply streamed to your device. Although cloud gaming services like Google Stadia and NVIDIA GeForce Now grabbed a lot of headlines when they were first only rumors, given these promises, it's easy to understand the growth and popularity of cloud gaming. Think about it. Bleeding-edge games on everyday devices. And in most cases, you don't even need to buy each individual game. Only pay a small monthly subscription fee. One thing is certain. Cloud gaming has definitely revolutionized the entry cost to high-performance gaming. Unfortunately, one way to kill a revolution is inaction. In the case of cloud gaming, that inaction is latency. Latency is the bane of the online/cloud gamer existence. Latency refers to how long it takes for data to travel between its source and a destination. The lower latency is, the better. In the terms of the cloud gamer, latency or lag is a delay in getting data from the device in your hands to a computer in the cloud and back again. So what does this look like when you're playing? Let's say you're running around the map, you notice someone that you can sneak up on, you get close and press the trigger to shoot. Then about a second later, you see the person turn around and shoot you. Gah, latency! So how do we minimize latency and get the most out of our experience? The first thing you should do is run a speed test and search for your ping value. Again, if we already know that latency is the time it takes for my controller and map data to go up to the server and to come back from the server, ping is the command that reports latency in a unit of time, normally in milliseconds. For an optimum gaming experience, we recommend striving for a ping of 50 milliseconds or lower. When your ping is 100 milliseconds or higher, your gaming experience will be severely degraded. If you can, always, and I mean always, get off of Wi-Fi and onto a hardline. There will be much lower signal degradation from the router. Okay, we know that it's not possible for everyone to avoid using Wi-Fi, say if you're on your phone, for example. In that case, Wi-Fi will be faster than cell data. Always try to use the 5 gigahertz connection. It will generally be faster with lower ping times. Also, make sure that you're in line of sight from your router. If you have to use a 2.4 gigahertz connection, these same rules apply. Okay, let's say you have followed all of these tips and you are still getting pings higher than 50 milliseconds. It may be time to replace your router. The best way to check this is by doing the following. Take a laptop to your router and modem. Connect the laptop via LAN to the router and run a speed test. Take note of the ping value. Next, connect the laptop directly to your cable modem and run the same speed test. If they're the same and you're still experiencing issues, it's your internet service provider. If these ping values are different, it might be time to buy a new router. It happens. Remember, older routers can't handle the amount of data and simultaneous streams of data that we're sending today. This leads to the final point. If you did all of these tips and improved your ping, don't ruin it by starting a gaming session while simultaneously streaming Netflix, downloading a Linux distribution, and uploading a YouTube video. Actually, if you're competing with me, go ahead and kill your latency. I won't mind a bit. Since you made it this far, how about a bonus tip? If your router supports prioritizing game traffic, do it. There will be times when you may need multiple devices connected for gameplay. Your router will make sure the devices running the game will get the most bandwidth. But I can't stress enough the importance of using this feature. I've seen people think they have the best internet, forget to implement this, and as soon as multiple devices start going, the internet comes to a crawl. So that does it. Now we can all go back to our friends and tell them again about the losses that we're going to be giving out. So schedule that Halo Infinite game after work and remember that this time will be different. We verified our connection and made sure our ping was lower than 50 milliseconds thanks to all of the tips. People, we will not fail. Remember, failure is not an option, at least not in this dojo. My name's Trisha Hirschberger, and I'll see you next time with more DIY in 5.